Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about merits and demerits of hard and soft water. So we already know what do we mean by hard water. Just to remind you that if the water possesses hardness, then the water is known as hard water. And I hope you remember that what is hardness? Hardness is the property of water due to which it does not give leather with soap properly. So it does not give leather with soap properly. Why? Because there are certain salts. Which salts I'm talking about? Dissolved salts of calcium and magnesium. So if dissolved salts of calcium and magnesium are present in water, and if you treat that water with soap, it does not give you leather properly. Rather, it gives you a precipitate or scum. And due to that property, you call that water as hard water. So definitely the soft water is that water which does not have those salts and which react with the soap properly. If you want to know more of it, you can check the other video. The link is posted here. Today we'll focus basically on what are the merits and demerits of hard water and soft water. So let us start with the merit first, because when we say when the water is hard, that means there are certain salts which are present in it, which are calcium and magnesium. But if they are present in it, the taste of the water becomes better, so you can, you know, drink it properly, because if these ions are not present, the water is of less taste. Secondly, to the plants are highly sensitive to the sodium level, because sometimes what happens is we treat the water with the ions like zeolite, some processes in order to clean the water. We use those processes, and because of that the sodium level in the water rises. So if it is hard water, it's basically, you know, it is okay because certain ions are present in it. Soft water do affect the growth because it does not have that ions in it, so you may call it as a merit of a soft water. Then there are effects on the health, definitely, but as such there are no serious adverse effect on the health. However, when the calcium and magnesium are present in the water, it actually strengthen our bone and teeth. It is required for us to drink. A daily supplement of calcium and magnesium is required. So if we drink soft water in which these salts are not there, definitely they are going to affect your bone and teeth. Then a coating of lime scale inside the pipe is actually helpful because it stops the poisonous salt to dissolve into the water. So when sometimes pipes are there and then there are cracks, and if lead pipes especially are there, the poisonous lead salt go inside the pipe. But if it a coating is there of the lime scale, because the water is hard, it actually prevents it. So you may take that positively. Secondly, directly or indirectly, this hard water actually helps in reducing the constipation and improving the digestion in our body. So this is the merit of a hard water. Let us go to the merit of soft water. Definitely, you can, you know, clean the clothes properly, clean the utensils properly if it is a soft water. Because as I said that hard water does not give leather properly, soft water do give. So definitely it's a plus point. Then yes, there would be impact on hair and skin. Your hair would not be dry, and your skin will become softer. Otherwise, if the scales are there due to hard water, they may impact your hair and skin. Silverware and glassware, yes, if you use dishwasher or you wash the utensils, it would be better if it is soft water. Otherwise, there will be scale due to hard water. The appliances also work better and their efficiency is increased if you are using soft water in them, because then there is no scale left in the appliance. Obviously, better plumbing would be there. There will be no coating on pipes and it will work properly. There will be no clogging in the pipes. Above all, you can, you know, convert it into money also, because if you are using less amount of soap and shampoo, that is how you are going to save the money. So you can take a positive point here. And obviously there will be no boiler trouble, because in a boiler you are supposed to boil the water, and when you boil the water the impurity is left behind. So if it is a hard water, those impurities are going to create a scale and a sludge in the boiler. There are other problems also, but if it is soft water, then there is no problem like that. So these are the merits of hard water, which is hardly discussed in any of the videos, or I have never seen much of it, but I think this will be useful to you. Let us go to demerits. You may be knowing it already, but let us just have a glimpse on it. First, obviously, hard water, if I say, I'm talking about hard water on the left. So obviously there'll be less formation of leather, and due to which your clothes are not going to get cleaned properly. Then spots and stains, definitely that is scum which is produced, that is stains the cloth. Sometimes the color of the cloth get faded, and the water marks are left on the utensils, bath tiles and bath fittings. So those spots appear on the glasses or silverware which you, if you use dishwasher. So there is a problem, spots and stains. Definitely there will be impact on hair. Hair becomes dry and rough, and your skin becomes dry and itchy. Actually, the minerals in the hard water, they change the pH balance of our skin, and that weakens you know, against harmful bacterial infection. So sometimes some kind of eczema like symptoms may appear on your skin also. When the appliances wear out earlier, or their efficiency is decreased, because when you're using hard water, they create a scale on the appliances, and that is how it affects the efficiency. With respect to the pipes, as I said, it not only corrode the pipe but also clog it. And sometimes, you know, the lime scale which forms inside the kettle, you might have observed in the daily life also, this creates wastage of energy when a kettle is used for boiling. So that scale creates a problem. It can lead to, in fact, galvanic corrosion also. Plants are at risk because hard water can cause blockage in the plant's root system. And definitely boiler troubles are there. While if you go to the soft water, there are certain health issues, because you know, when it is treated with especially like zeolite process, when the sodium level in the water is higher in proportion to the soft water, then it is especially harmful for those who are sensitive to it, like diabetic people or who are having very high BP. Similarly, the plants are also sensitive to sodium level. So normally we say that distilled or, you know, neutral water is best for their growth. Fishes also feel, you know, fluctuation in pH can harm or kill fish. So soft water basically cannot be used in aquarium. That is a demerit, because soft water is susceptible to pH fluctuation, and while fish require a strict pH level. Then coming to the lead poisoning, as I already said that through lead pipes or lead containers, soft water can easily lead to poisoning, while it's not happens in the hard water, because then there is a coating of scale. Obviously the soft water is tasteless and it's not pleasant to drink, because the ions are not present in it. And obviously soft water does not help in strengthening our bones, because it lack that special supplement of calcium and magnesium both. So these are the demerits of hard water and soft water. Now let us quickly compile this presentation by saying that when I say hard water is that water which does not produce leather with soap. Why? Because of the salts of calcium and magnesium. And majorly, when it is used, your fuel and time is always wasted, because you have to heat it a little more, and time is money. So obviously money also is wasted. Cleaning quality of soap is decreased and the wastage is increased. It always creates boiler troubles like sludge and scale, boiler corrosion, caustic embrittlement, priming, foaming, etc. You may see, I am going to make a video on boiler trouble very soon. Then industries also suffer loss, because what happens in textile and dye industries, the hard water is there, then patches appear on the fabric, you know, and it distorts the design of the fabric. In sugar industry also there is a problem of crystallization. In paper industry also there is blots on the paper. So these industries also suffer loss if they use hard water for their, you know, application. And obviously hard water is slightly harmful for drinking and potable purposes, because it do have a merit of calcium and magnesium, but then these salts in excess can create a trouble. So I think with this I am able to let you know the merits and demerits of hard water. Thank you so much for putting trust onto me and subscribing my channel, and if you do like, just do mention a comment. Thank you so much.